Hello, Mr. Butcher. My name is Ellison Moore, and I'm in your A2 class. And this is my factor in quadratics expressions video. So, for my first one, I have an easy case trinomial. So, that means that there's no number in front of the x value. That's what makes it an easy case. So, as you can see, my a value is 1. My b value is negative 7x, and my c value is negative 18. So my c value would go in the top of my diamond method, and I would have to find two numbers that multiply to give me negative 18 and add to give me negative 7. So as I can see, my numbers are negative 9 and negative 2 because they both add to give me multiply to give me negative 18 and add to give me negative 7. So when I do it, when I factor out my expression, I'm going to have x minus 9, because as you can see, it's right here, and I'm factoring out my x. So, and then I'm going to have x plus 2. And when I multiply these out, I would get the same number that I started with. Okay. Moving along, this is my difference of perfect squares. As I see, both of these are perfect squares, so that means that I can factor a perfect square out of both of them. As you can see, x squared is a perfect square, which we can factor out x and an x, and negative 64 is a perfect square, which we can also factor out an 8. And now my solution is x plus 8 and x minus 8, which will give me x squared if we multiply them, and negative 64. Here's my greatest common factor. As you can see, as I'm looking at the equation, I notice that I can factor out of the numbers, I notice that I can factor out an x. No, I've noticed that I can factor out a 4. So when I'm looking at my n values, I see n to the 4th, n to the 3rd, and n to the 2nd. And I see that I can factor out an n to the 2nd, because that is my lowest common term. So right here, we'll go on the outside, because it's a GCF. So my greatest common factor will go on the outside. Now, right here, I got this equation from here. I see that negative 7n squared times negative 4n squared would give me 28n to the 4th. And I see that 4n squared plus times 4n will give me 16n to the 3rd. And I see that 4n squared times negative 20 will give me 80n squared. Now, I'm not done here. My expression can be factored a little bit more because we have to get it to the simplest term. So my 7n, I can pull out an n out of there, and it would just make it 7n. Now, I can see that 4n can be factored with just an n. That's where I got my n from, because 4n and 4n, 4n can be factored with just an n. My 20, it can be factored with a negative 10 and a 2 to give me 20. So negative 10 and 2 would give me negative 20. Okay, my hard case trinomial. I know that this is a hard case trinomial because there's a number in front of my value. So, in order to get my diamond method, I will have to multiply my a value times my c value. And my a value times my c value will give me 42. So then again, when we do up here to the easy case, we have to do down here. What two numbers will add to give me 42? Multiply to give me 42 and add to give me 17. And as I can see, 14 and 3 would add to give me 42. And, would multiply to give me 42 and add to give me 17. So, as I'm putting it into an equation, I know that I would take these two and split the equations as opposed to my 17b. So when I got 2b, which is what I started with, I would get plus 14b because it's right here. And then for my next equation, I would get 3b. I'm taking the 3b right here, and I'm adding it to my original equation, which is plus 21. So when I factor it out, I know that I have a greatest common factor, which is 2b, because 2b can go into here, and 2b can go into here. And then when I factor out a 2b from this one, I would get a b. And then when I factor out a 2 from this one, I get 7. 7b. So that's why we have 2b and b plus 7. And I notice that I have a greatest common factor of 3. When I factor out a 3 from this one, I'm going to get b. And when I factor out a 3 from this one, I'm going to get 7. And one thing you notice about hard case is that when you factor them out, the equations, they have to be equal to each other. This equation has to match this equation. This is not a coincidence, b plus 7 and b plus 7. They always have to be the same. So, with that being said, I'm still not done with my equation. So, I would take these two equations, b plus 7, and put this in parentheses because as clearly you can see. And then, I would take my outside values and put them also into an expression, plus 3. And now my equation is finally solved.